Right, so it's been a while, and judging from if you can hear that in my voice, I'm coming off the tail end of a quite bad cold. I just couldn't, I couldn't film. I could barely stream. I tried streaming the other night, and it was, painful to say the least. But yeah. The old throat is getting back to where it usually is. A few lockets, some soothers, and it should be back to normal. But yeah, I want to talk about Iron Man. I think the book's pretty good. The Cantwell run is finished. 3 issues into the Duggan run. I haven't started it yet, but from what I've heard, that run is still just as good, if not better, than what Cantwell did. And having just finished Cantwell's run, I have, then yeah, that Duggan run is probably really good because the Cantwell stuff is really good. I did do a video talking about the first like 12 issues on their own and what I thought of those, and that everything after that, it doesn't really hit those highs, but the final arc is basically Tony Stark buying up the or like basically doing like spy espionage story to try and find the Ten Rings to buy up all of these like really powerful weapons, or the most powerful weapons in the Marvel Universe, and from this like big tech company that are like manufacturing and trading off the most powerful weapons in the Marvel Universe. And I think it's the whole like story and what's going on in the book isn't really the point. It's more the way that Cantwell is writing Tony Stark and the way that he gets the character. And it's not really about what he's doing. It's more about like what the characterization of Iron Man. I feel like the characterization of Iron Man in this book from issue 1 to issue 20 is damn near perfect. It's like exactly what I would think of Iron Man. When I think Iron Man, I think this book. I read it pretty much in the voice of Robert Downey Jr., and it felt like, it felt like Iron Man. Like classic Iron Man. It just felt like a good Iron Man book, and Iron Man hasn't really been a book that I've. It's been like Fantastic Four for me. It's been a book that I've picked up all the time, but it's never really been a book where I've been like, I cannot wait until the next issue. I can't wait until to see what happens next. But with Cantwell, it's been like, I can. I'm really invested in what's going on. But like I said, the Korvac stuff was better. The Korvac stuff was really good. That's not me saying that every issue after that. I think issue 20 as just like an issue on its own is great. Yeah, I like issue 20 on its own. But I think that arc that will take us into the Duggan run, it leaves an interesting point of Riri Williams now having the Ten Rings. And it'll be interesting to see how that goes going forward. And Riri Williams has been a character for a while. she's been in the comics for nigh on 5 years. And, you know, she's obviously she's going to be a big thing in the MCU in the next couple years. So, you know, obviously she's going to get a push in the comics as well. And it's interesting because, like, Miles and Peter, we see Miles and Peter interact all the time. Riri and Iron Man and Tony, barely ever. So it'll be interesting to see, going forward, an actual dynamic between those two characters actually form, and to see what their relationship is going to be like. Because obviously, I've not followed much of Ironheart. I didn't read her run when Tony Stark was in a coma. I didn't. I haven't read like much stuff. I haven't seen much stuff where Ironheart and Iron Man, or Riri and Tony, actually, you know, actually like converse. I haven't seen those two in the same comic, I don't think ever, or rarely ever. And that's weird for me, because, like, the legacy character almost always is, like, they're just a secondary character in the book now. Or they have team-ups, like, at least one team-up a year. Like, Sam and Steve with Captain America and Falcon, they're going into this big like Cold War event where like Bucky's an actual villain now, like he's actually evil. And it's like I haven't been reading either Captain America book at the moment. Maybe I should, because apparently both of them are very good, and like I don't know if this Cold War event is going to be important to the rest of the universe or just Captain America. But yeah, I don't know why I'm not reading that, because I enjoyed, for what it was, I did kind of like the Ta-Nehisi Coates run for most of it. Not all of it, but most of it I enjoyed. And this Iron Man run I've enjoyed as well. And I do find it kind of weird that we haven't seen an interaction between Riri and Tony. This book is the first time, and it was only in issue 19, you know, the second to last issue, and issue 20 is just a celebration issue, the 650th issue of Iron Man. Why that's important, I don't know. It's not like bang on 700. But yeah, I liked a lot of what was going on in this book from beginning to end. There are a few issues, like the first couple issues and the couple issues after, like between arcs, there would just be filler stuff. And I don't like that. I kind of like a one and done, and I kind of like seeing Iron Man or Tony, how he gets out of situations without his armor. And there are a few issues where they do that in like one and dones. I like having more time put onto something like that. If you're going to do it in like a two issue. If you're going to do like a filler thing, make the filler thing like a two issue arc. Don't have like one issue where Tony Stark is fighting a sentient gorilla, because that just takes you out of it. You have an issue where you're dealing with like alcoholism and depression and that, and then the next issue is, oh, we're going to fight a big gorilla. We're going to fight a sentient gorilla. And it's like, ugh. The other thing I like is that Cantwell is actually shining a light on like the D-list characters, like Gargoyle and Frogman and like Tony's new like love interest for this story arc, or for this run, and hopefully going into the next one as well, because I really like the relationship between Tony and Hellcat, and I think this is as much a secret Hellcat book as it is an Iron Man book, and I love that. But yeah, I really enjoyed most of this book. Again, that one issue, but I'm not going to say out of 20, one issue is like dragging the whole thing down, because it's not. I'd be lying if I said that. But yeah, there's not really too much more to talk about, because I did talk about the whole Korvac, stuff, and that those 12 issues in a video already. So if you want a more detailed look at what I thought of those, the first 12 issues of Count Wall's Iron Man run, then yeah, go read those, or go watch those, and pick up the book if you can find a trade of the Korvac issues, like issues 1 through 12, and then the rest of the book, or the rest of the series. It's a really good read, and the best Iron Man has been in a while. Like, the best Iron Man book that has come out in a while. And I'm really excited to see what Duggan does, because everything I've read from Jerry Duggan has been amazing. His Deadpool run was great. His, like, I'm sure there's other books that he's written that have been great. I just haven't read a lot of them. But yeah, if it's anything like what he did with, with Deadpool, then yeah, I can see him doing a really good job. But yeah, he's got big shoes to fill, because Christopher Cantwell's whole niche seems to be like billionaires that are assholes, that are trying to make amends. Like, he's been doing the Norman Osborn Gold Goblin book. He did Doom. Doom not necessarily trying to make amends in that book, but still, you know, he's a billionaire asshole. So I'd want him to take on like a Black Panther book at some point, and, you know, characterize him the same way that John Ridley's been characterizing him. The Ridley book's ending soon, or already ended, so I guess you can technically finish that, or go into the next arc and give Black Panther to Christopher Cantwell, because he's like the only billionaire superhero that Cantwell hasn't written at this point. But yeah, I will see you guys in the next video. Let me know in the comments below what you're thinking of Iron Man. If I'm not back in a few days, it'll be because this throat has either gotten worse or because I've just completely lost my voice in general. Maybe the point. Probably shouldn't have filmed today, but yeah, it's a shorter one. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.